My dear students, today I am going to teach you about the official compounds of the iodine. Our discussion is divided in 5 parts: introduction, importance of iodine, hypo and hyperthyroidism, compounds containing iodine, and radioactive iodine and sodium iodide. Now, as far as iodine is concerned, it is one of the essential trace elements and it is used as an iodide salt. Iodide salt or iodine itself, its preparation, its compound have to be considered from twofold regions. First is its systemic use and biochemical role, iodine and its preparation for the topical application. So here I would like to tell iodine preparations are used basically for two purposes. One is systemic and another is the topical. So my dear students, here you should not get confused, because topical preparations cannot be used for systemic use and the systemic preparations cannot be used for the topical use. So therefore, the applications of iodine are divided in two parts simply: for one for systemic use and biochemical role, and second one is for the topical application. As far as topical applications are concerned, this topic is covered in the separate chapter. In this chapter, we will deal with the iodine and its compound that are mainly for systemic use and for the biochemical role. If we look upon the requirement of the iodine, for male it is 140 microgram per day, for female it is 100 microgram per day. Usually it is obtained from diet, and the common sources are table salt, eggs, codfish, yogurt, and most of the iodine is obtained from the iodized table salt. Iodine is important as it is absorbed from our food into the blood circulation, and here it plays an important role in the synthesis of two thyroid hormone, that is known as thyroxine and triiodothyronine. Here you have to recall one more point: thyroxine is known as T4 and triiodothyronine is known as the T3. So thyroxine is T4 and triiodothyronine is the T3. So iodine is as important as its role in thyroxine and triiodothyronine. They are also known as T4 and the T3, and these hormones are essential for normal growth and development, and they also plays important role in the energy metabolism. If you look on the structure, in thyroxine there are 4 iodine atoms. In triiodothyronine, there are the 3 iodine atoms. Here are the enlarged structure of the T4 and T3. If we see biochemically, both of them are synthesized from the tyrosine amino acid. Now let's focus on the importance of the iodine. Thyroxine is a storage form of hormone, whereas triiodothyronine, we are talking about the T4 and T3. So T4 is the storage form of hormone and the T3 is the circulating form. Biochemical role of these two hormones is to increase the metabolic rate through increasing the oxidative processes in the body. Iodine can be administered internally, and after administration, this iodine is reduced to iodidine, GIT. Here is the one challenge, that iodine is water insoluble. Therefore, the source of iodine like sodium iodide is preferred for the internal administration due to its water solubility. The absorbed iodine is normally utilized for the synthesis of thyroid hormone. After administration of iodine, its uptake is governed by the various factors like condition of local thyroid tissue, the concentration of inorganic iodide in the blood, and the anterior pituitary hormone thyrotropin level in the blood. So these all together, these three factors control the amount or uptake of the iodine in the blood. Hypothyroidism is the deficiency disease of the thyroid hormone. In this disease, metabolic processes are slowed down and they lead to the enlargement of the thyroid gland, that is known as the goiter, and it is characterized by the swelling of neck. In Hindi, it is also known as the Ghenga Rog. One more disorder that is controlled under hypothyroidism is known as cretinism. In cretinism, the person is mentally retarded and he is deaf. And this disease or this deficiency occurs only when? Since birth. So for the treatment of hypothyroidism, we generally use sodium iodide or potassium iodide. Similarly, excess of the thyroid is called hyperthyroidism. In this, thyroid hormone is secreted in excess amount, and this hypothyroidism is detected by exophthalmos. Dhyan dijiyega, it is detected by exophthalmos. In this, eyeballs get enlarged, and for the treatment of hyperthyroidism, antithyroid drugs like carbamazole, methimazole are used. Now, if we talk about the chemistry of iodine, its molecular formula is I2. It is a heavy bluish black rhombic prism or plate with metallic luster. Here, focus on this point, although it is a non-metal, but it is having the metallic luster. It has peculiar order, means we can identify iodine with the help of its order, and it can volatilize, means it is easily converted into the vapors at ordinary temperature, and this process is called as sublimation. So iodine exhibits the phenomenon of sublimation. At high temperature, it undergoes the melting. It is practically insoluble in water but soluble in alcohol. Now, if we want to solubilize in water, we need to add potassium iodide. So, in the presence of potassium iodide, iodine is soluble in water. Why? It is so due to the formation of polyiodides. As far as the chemical properties of iodine are concerned, it can easily react with metals as well as the non-metal. With iron, it react easily to give the ferrous iodide. Reducing agents can easily react with aqueous iodine solution and they get oxidized. One famous reaction is reaction between sodium thiosulfate and iodine. It easily convert into sodium iodide and sodium tetrathionate. Iodine also react with alkali to form iodide and iodate when heated. Iodine is useful in its aqueous as well as alcoholic solution form, and in this form it is used for as a germicide and as a fungicide. It is also used in the treatment of hypothyroidism, in which deficiency of iodine takes place, for purification of drinking water. It is also used as an antidote in the alkaloid poisoning. It is very useful in case of the thin layer chromatography, that is also commonly known as the TLC, as a locating agent or as an identifying agent. It is a very good reactant in case of the oxidation reduction titrations. Iodine is incompatible with turpentine oil. It gets violent in presence of turpentine. It reacts with ammonia or ammoniated mercury to form again explosive iodide of nitrogen. It reacts with alkali hydroxide and carbonates to form iodide or iodates. Aqueous solution of alkaloid salt are treated with iodide, alkaloids get precipitated. So overall, it is incompatible with turpentine oil, ammonia type compounds, alkali hydroxide and alkaloid salts. Iodine can be stored in amber color bottles with tight glass stopper, and it should be kept in a cool place. Next compound to be discussed is the sodium iodide. The formula of sodium iodide is sodium N. Sodium is represented as N and iodine is represented as the I. So formula is NaI. This compound is official in IP. It can be prepared by the addition, of the slight excess of iodine to concentrated solution of sodium hydroxide. By reacting with concentrated solution of sodium hydroxide, it gives sodium iodide and sodium iodate. Now this remaining amount of sodium iodide is further reduced with the carbon to give the yield of the sodium iodide. Sodium iodide is the white crystalline odorless powder. It is hygroscopic in nature. So we are talking about here is the physical and well as well as the chemical properties. So it is white crystalline odorless powder. It is hygroscopic in nature, means it take water from the moisture and it create the stability issue. It may decompose on storage and develop brown color, that is called air oxidation, and it is due to the liberation of the free iodine. Sodium iodide is soluble in water and alcohol. Here I would like to mention that these physical properties we can denote with the word letters COST, color, odor, solubility and taste. So it is white crystalline color, odor of iodide or iodine, soluble in water, and its taste is the alkaline. Its taste is the alkaline or simply the saline. It has the saline taste. It easily react with silver nitrate to give yellow precipitate of the silver iodide. Oxidizing agent लाइक सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड रिएक्ट इजिली विद सोडियम आयोडाइड टू लिबरेट आयोडीन. If you talk about the incompatibility of sodium iodide is incompatible with the acid and it decomposes to liberate the iodine. And iodine can be easily precipitated with the solution of alkaloids. So it is incompatible with acid and alkaloids. As far as storage is concerned, it should be stored in the well closed container and should be kept in a dry place. Iodine is used as a phlebotic agent to treat syphilis and the leprosy. Iodide salt were also used as a to treat the fungal infection. Iodide salt like potassium iodide, sodium iodide are used as a expectorant. You must have listened this word and must have read earlier. Expectorants are the agents. They are basically mucolytic. They are used to expel out the productive material that is present inside our larynx. It is also useful in the treatment of asthma and chronic bronchitis. If one get by mistake administered the overdose of iodine, it causes toxicity and the condition is known as the iodism. In this condition, we use sodium chloride to counter the action of the iodide salts. Now the last compound of iodine to be discussed is the radioactive iodine and sodium iodide. Mainly it is a radioactive sodium iodide. So before proceeding further, we should be able to recall what are the isotopes. Isotopes are the elements having the same atomic number but different in atomic weight or mass. Here the example is H1, H2 and H3. So they are the isotopes of the hydrogen, known as hydrogen, deuterium and tritium. So there are two major sources of types of isotopes, stable isotopes and unstable isotopes. And unstable isotopes exhibit the radioactive phenomena. So there are several radioactive isotopes of iodine, but majorly that is being used clinically is the iodine-131. And it is obtained by the irradiation of the tellurium. It is obtained by the irradiation of the tellurium and used in the form of sodium iodide. The solution of radioactive sodium iodide is official and the strength should be 90 to 110%. It is a clear colored solution and its half-life is 8.04 days. It emits beta and gamma radiations and the pH of its solution should be in between 7 to 10. Now, if we talk about uses, so radioactive iodine is used to diagnosis of the disorder of the thyroid function like hypothyroidism, hyperthyroidism, goiter, and simultaneously it is also used for the treatment of the hyperthyroidism. Iodine-123 has a half-life of 13 days. It emits X-rays only. So it can be used for the thyroid scan. So I hope you must have understand about the iodine and its official compound. Thank you, students.